Welcome all. My name is Deco Mohammed. I'm your host. So today focus is still trading and profit and loss account. As most of you have requested, and I was checking through your comments, most of you have requested another lecture on trading profit and loss account with adjustment. So today I'm going to do a simple illustration of trading profit and loss account, which is called the income statement, which has some illustrations. So I have here a question on the board, of which I like to read out first, then I illustrate. So here we have the following balances were extracted from the books of Peter Business. So we have the debit and the credit. We have capital, 250,000, stock, 1st January 2018, 25,000. We have plant and machinery, 250,000. Motor vehicle at cost, 80,000. We have provision for depreciation, plant and machinery, 20,000. We have provision for depreciation of motor vehicle, 16,000. Purchase and sales, the purchase is 360,000 and sales is 600,000. Returns inward is 40,000, outward is 20,000. Wages and salaries. Wages and salaries, 60,000. Then we have discount, the one of the debit is 5,000 and credit is 4,000. Carriage inward, 2,500. Carriage outward, 3,000. Postage and telephone, 7,500. Water and electricity, 8,600. Bad debts, 1,500. General expenses, 8,500. Provision for bad debt, 1,000. Rent and rates, 15,000. Account receivable, 55,000. Account payable, 46,000. Cash in hand, 6,000. Cash at bank, 30,000. Total, 957,600. Additional information. Number one, depreciation is to be charged at 10% of cost of land and machinery and 20% of cost of motor vehicle. Number two, closing stock on that 1st December 2018 was valued at 22,500. Number three, accrued rent KES 3,000 and prepaid rates are KES 1,000. Number four, outstanding electricity expenses is KES 600. Number five, provision for bad debt is to be increased by KES 300. Required: A, prepare income statement for the year ended at 1st December 2018, Part B, statement of financial position. Statement of financial position as at that date. As to prepare the income statement and the financial position statement. So, before I prepare the income statement, I like to do, there are four adjustments. Here we have four adjustments that I would like to illustrate. The four adjustments that we have here, the first one is on, we have the depreciation, we have the bad provision for bad debt, and also we have the accrued electricity. So we can say, we can see here workings. We can have here workings. We said our first working is going to be on depreciation. Let's always start with the provision for bad debt. Let's start with the provision for bad debt. What our working one is the provision for bad debt. Remember, here in the question, we are told the provision for bad debt is 1,000. We have the one for the provision that we have in the question is 1,000. And additional information, we are told the provision for bad debt, it is to be increased by KES 300. It's to be increased by KES 300. If it is increased by 300, that means it will end up to 1,300. See, this provision is short and clear, because
we have already been told, whether it's already, we are told it's already an increase. But now, there are some instances whereby we are not being told the figure of increase we are supposed to calculate. Maybe you are told in the additional information, provision for bad debt is set at 5% of the debtors. If that is the case, you need to calculate 5% of the debtors, it will give you how much. From there, now you compare that with the initial amount to know whether it is an increase or a decrease. And for symbol clarification, this provision is the amount set out by the company. Like this company has set out that they say that 1,000, the amount of 1,000 will not be raised. It's like they are forgotten, they are treated as a bad debt. And this 1,300, we are going to subtract it from the debtors. Am I clear? Here we have two scenarios. I said, increase in provision is an expenses, while a decrease is an income. If for this case, if this depreciation, if it could have been decreased, let's say by 100, that means it could have gone to 900 and against 1,000. That 100 will have been an income because it is a decrease. But this case, we already been told it has been increased. So increase is an expenses. So this 300 is going to be an expenses in the income statement. And the total amount, we are going to subtract it from the debtors. I hope I'm clear. This 300, we are going to treat it as an expenses because of the increase in provision of doubtful debt. While that 1,300, we are going to subtract from the debtors. If our case, we could have a decrease, then that would have been an income. But since it's an increase, it's an expenses. Now, the provision for bad debt, we have the depreciation. We have the depreciation. So, on the depreciation, we are told is to be charged as 10% of cost of plant and machinery. 10%. So it is 10 over 100 multiplied by the cost here. It is 250,000. From the question, it is 250,000. Since I already worked out, this is going to be how much? 10% of 250. That will give us 25,000. 25,000. And this question must be very keen. Here we are told on cost. But if they could have said on reducing balance, we could not have used 250. We could have less out first the provision. 250 minus 20. Then that's what they're going to calculate. If the question could have been said on reducing balance method, we could have reduced this amount first. Since we are told it is on cost, that we use direct 250. Next is, the next depreciation is on motor vehicle, 20%. This is the first depreciation. It is, this is plant and machinery, P and M. Then let's have the depreciation for machinery. Let's have here machinery. Let's have this as working one, W1. Let's say this is working two. Then let's have machinery as working three. Depreciation on machinery. Depreciation on machinery. It is going to be 20%. It is going to be 20%. Multiply it. 20% multiplied by 80,000, which was the cost, which is 16,000. Now, you're almost done. We have calculated the provision, the depreciations. Now our third adjustment is concerning this accrued rent. These accrued expenses, they are treated, they affect the income statement, they also affect the balance sheet or the financial position statement. This accrued rent, we are going to add the initial amount in the trial balance. We are going to add the accrued rent. Prepaid, we subtract. Because this accrued, it means it has accrued, it has not been paid. We are going to incur it for the next month. So you need to add back. But prepaid, we subtract. Again, all accrued expenses are current liabilities, while all prepaid expenses are current asset. So all prepaid we are going to treat as current asset, and all accrued we are going to treat as current liability. So for our case here, here we have rent. From the question, the amount of rent and rates, where rent is 15,000. So we are going to have as working, this is working three. We're going to say rent and rates. Remember the initial amount was 15,000. We had as 15,000. This was the initial from the trial balance. But we are told accrued rent 3,000. So we are going to say add accrued of 3,000. That comes to 18,000. On the same paragraph, we are told prepaid rents are cash shillings 1,000. So prepaid we less. Now we say less prepaid of 1,000. This comes to 17,000. So the amount we are going to use as rent and rates is 17,000. Number four, last one, is concerning the electricity. We are done with depreciation, we are done with the accrued rent and rates. The last one is electricity. The original amount of electricity from the question is, water electricity is 8,600. So we have here, water and electricity is 8,600. But there is as outstanding means it's also accrued. So we say add outstanding as 600. So if we add 8,600 plus 600, that will come to how much? From here, I could see this is 9,200. That is 9,200. So we have shown all the workings. Now we are going to illustrate. And I'm keen on the provision, because this question was direct. We have already been told that it is increased. Some question, they will give you the provision of this provision in the trial balance. Then we are told in the additional information that the provision is set at 5% of debtors. So it means you have to calculate 5% of the debtors. Then the amount you have gotten, compare it with the initial amount. If it is high, that means it's an increase. If it is low, it's a decrease. Get the difference. The difference can either be increase or decrease. If it is an increase, that is an expenses. If it is a decrease, that's an income. So I have shown all the workings. Now I want to do the part one, which is the income statement. Allow me to wrap the board so that I can do the income statement. Peter business income statement. For the year ended 31st December 2018. So we have already calculated, so there's no need of me repeating. So I have the figures. I can just move on. So here I have the sales. So here I have shillings. Here we also have shillings. The sales is 600,000. Next. From this sales, we need to less the return inward. So we say less return inward. Return inward, the amount from the question, it was 40,000. Remember returns, we have been given the debit and the credit. The one on the debit side, it is a return inward, or what you call it, sale return. And the one on the credit is return outward or purchase return. Now this return inward is the sale return. That's why we are going to less it from the sales for us to get the net sale.
So our net sale here is 560,000. This is our net. Our net sale. Then from there we have the opening stock. Let's have the opening stock. Opening stock. The figure of the opening stock, it is 25,000. Then we add carriage inward. Sorry, let's have the purchase first. We are going to have the purchase. Purchase. The amount of purchase from the question, it is 360,000. Then from this purchase, we need to add carriage. We add carriage. Carriage inward. From the question, the carriage inward is 2500. Then from this we less return outward, what we call purchase return. Return outward. Return outward, the amount there, it was 20,000. So we less 20,000. Now the amount we get, if we subtract, if we add 360,000 to 2500, subtract 20,000, the amount you get there is 342,500. Now, this one we add back to the, we add it to the opening stock, we get the cost of good available for sale. Of which if we add, we are going to get 367,500. Then from there, we less the closing stock. Less closing stock. Closing stock. Less the closing stock. The closing stock we had, it was given in the additional information, which was 22,500. So we less 22,500. So at the amount we get there, it is the cost of sales. Cost of sales, we write it here. Now the cost of sales, the amount you are going to get there is cost of sales. In fact, when we reach here the net sale, we need to say, we are supposed to say less cost of sales. Less cost of sales. Of which we had the opening stock, purchase, carriage inward, return outward, cost of good available of sale. Then we get the closing stock. Now this cost of sales is the amount we get here. After we subtract the closing stock, we get the cost of sales. Now the cost of sales is 345,000. Then less it from the net sale. This net sale, remember this net sale is what we less it. We less it from the cost of sales. And if you take 560 is more than 345, that we have, we are going to have a gross profit of how much? A gross profit of 21, of 215,000. Now, is there any other income? I remember we only have one income, which was the discount received. Now we are going to add. Remember, if the bad debt, the provision for bad debt was a decrease, we could have write it as an income. Since it was an increase, it is expenses. But for now, the only income we have is discount received. So we say add discount. We add the discount received. From the question, the discount received was 4,000. Remember, it was on the credit side. All expenses have a debit balance, while all income have a credit balance. So discount received is 4,000. Then total income is going to be how much? 219,000. Now, from this, we less expenses. We say less expenses. The expenses we have wages and salaries. Wages wages and salaries. This is 60,000. Then we continue. We have the discount allowed. Remember, it was on the debit side. Discount allowed. We have the discount. Discount allowed. From the question, the discount allowed was 5,000. 5,000. Then we have carriage outward. We have the carriage outward. We have the carriage. Carriage outward. Carriage outward. The amount there is 3,000. After carriage outward, we have postage and telephone. We have the postage. Postage and telephone. Postage and telephone. The amount there is 7,500. Then next we have water and electricity. Water and electricity. Remember, it was working number 4. So we can say here bracket W4 to show that it is working 4. The amount there was 9,200. 9,200. Next, bad debt written off. Bad debt written off. Bad debt. Bad debt written off. The amount there is 1,500. Then we have the rent and rate. Rent. Rent and rate. Rent and rate. The amount there, it was working number 3. Remember, we are having 15K. We add accrued of 3. We subtracted prepaid of 1,000. So the amount was coming to 17,000. So it is working 3. Which comes to 17,000. Then we need to record the increase in doubtful debt, which was working number one. The 300, we already been told from the question, they increased by 300. So we need to record that as an expenses. We say increase in doubtful debt. The amount we have there is 300. Then the last two is the depreciation, which was working number 2. So we call it DEP, depreciation. We can have on plant, depreciation on plant and machinery. This is working number 2. We calculate as 25,000, as 25,000. Then we have the depreciation. Depreciation on motor vehicle. On motor vehicle. The amount there was working number 2, 16K. Working number 2, 16,000. Now we have exhausted all the expenses we need to add. So if you add 6K to 5K to 3K to 7,500, 9,200, 1,500, 8,500. Sorry, we have missed the general expenses. We have not recorded the general expenses. So I can add it from here. We forgot the general expenses. General expenses, it was 8,500. 8,500. 8,500. So if we add 6,000 to 5,000 to 3,000 to 7,500 to 9,200 to 8,500, 1,500, 17,000, 300, 25,000, 16,000, we're going to get a total amount of 153,000. Now this 153 you are going to less from the income. So it is 219 against 153. Obviously you're going to have a net profit. A net profit of how much? 219 against 153, it is 66,000. You're going to have a 66,000. So that's the net profit. We have the trading profit and loss account. Let me wrap. We are done with the first part. Let's go to the next part. So it is Peter business. Peter business. Then we have statement of financial position. Statement of financial. Statement of financial position as at 31st December 2018. Now let's have, we are going to start with the fixed asset. Fixed asset. So we have the plant and machinery. Plant and machinery. So here we're going to have the cost, the depreciation, and then the net book value, NBV, the net book value. So the cost of plant and machinery is 250,000. Now the depreciation, we consider both the one we calculated and the provision given in the question, and the provision given in the question. So it means this is going to be 20,000 plus 16,000. Remember, the 16,000 we calculated in the as depreciation, but 20 it was provision. So we add both to get the total provision, to get the total depreciation, which comes to 45. So 45 against 250, we're going to get 205,000. Next is motor vehicle. Motor vehicle. The amount for motor vehicle is 80,000. Then that's the cost. The depreciation, we're going to add this 25 plus the 16,000 we calculated here, plus the 16,000 given in the trial balance. For the first part, 25,000 is what we calculated as the plant and machinery depreciation, but 16,000 it was as a provision. So that's why it was 45. But for the motor vehicle, we calculated 16,000 as the depreciation, and the provision was 16,000. So we're going to add 16 plus 16, which comes to 32,000. So 80, take away 32, you're going to get 48,000. So if we add 48 to 205, you're going to get 253,000. This is the total asset. Total asset. Now let's go to, this is total fixed asset. Fixed asset, not the asset, but only the fixed asset. Let's go to the current asset. Current asset. Current asset, we have the cash in hand. Cash in hand, which was 6,000. Then we have the cash at the bank. Cash at bank. The amount there was 30,000. Then we have the account receivable. Account receivable. Remember, this is a debtor. And we say this 1,300, we subtract it from the debtors. The amount here is 55,000. 55,000. We say less provision for debt. Less provision for debt, which was 1,300. 1,300, it is the 1,000 plus the increase of 300, which is 1,300. So subtract
Retire from 1300, you get 53,700.
Then we have the stock. The stock there is 22,500.
We're using the closing stock.
Then we have recorded the asset, the current asset, but we say all prepaid are current asset. Remember, we are having a prepaid rate. We are having a prepaid rate there. So we say here, prepaid rate. Prepaid rate of how much? 1,000. So what is the total here? The total current asset here, the amount of total asset is 113,200. 113,200.
Then from this we are going to add
this 113,200. We are going to add
253,000. We are going to add 253,200. 250,000,
we get the total asset. The total asset comes to 366,200.
Remember, the balance sheet must balance. So our liability also should also be 366,200. Now let's go to capital plus liabilities. So let's have the capital.
Capital, the amount we have capital is 250,000.
We add 250,000. Then we add the net profit.
The net profit was 66,000. That comes to 316,000. If we add the two,
we'll have here 316,000.
So there are only two current liabilities. We only have two current liabilities.
So we go for current liabilities.
We have the accounts payable.
Accounts payable is also called the creditors account payable.
The amount there is 46,600. We also have the accrued rent. All accrued are
liabilities, current liabilities. We have the accrued rent as 3,000.
Then we also have the outstanding electricity.
Outstanding is also accrued. So we have outstanding electricity.
Outstanding electricity is 600. Then total
comes here to 50,200. So if we add, you should be able to get 366,200 as the total capital. This is total capital plus liabilities. It balances. I hope you enjoyed the class. It's my pleasure to have you in this session. We have discussed everything. So, hope to see you next time. It is bye from me.